Lights, camera, action, take one. Hello everyone, I'm Jess the Book Freak and welcome to my channel. Today I am reviewing Dexter's Final Cut by Jeff Lindsay, the seventh and penultimate book in the Dexter book series. Woo, number seven! Do you like my hat? This book is about the magic of making television. I figured this would be appropriate. I felt very artistic and inspired by this book. Well, not really, but I just thought of like movies, TV shows, so, or it just looks like I'm gonna go golfing. I'm not really sure. Anyway, so I'm giving a warning that anything from books 1 through 6, I might bring up if I'm talking about this book. I'm not gonna spoil this book, but the ones before that, I'm not sure. So if you notice, this book is called Dexter's Final Cut and there is no alliteration. And you're like, well, why? Why is there no alliteration? What's going on? And even the author, he acknowledges this and he says, this book is a lot different than all the other books. So that's why there's no alliteration. It stands out. I've read a lot of reviews. Some people really like it and some people really don't. And the previous book, some people really liked it, some people didn't. I liked it. This one, well, you'll find out. What's going on in this book, there's this television series, a crime scene show that's taking place in Miami. The studios are asking the Miami Police Department to consult on the show. So Dexter has someone, this famous actor, Robert Chase, shadow him for a while. Well, because he's going to be playing a blood spatter analyst, just like Dexter. So Dexter has this person following him around. He doesn't really like that. And Deb is also assigned a beautiful actress named Jackie Forrest, and she's gonna be playing a detective. Deb is not enthused about this because there's a killer on the loose and she cannot work on this case. Or can she? So the killer of this book, what he does to the bodies is that he looks for blonde women, takes out their eye, and leaves a certain fluid in their eye hole. Very gross and disturbing. So there's been these women who fit a certain profile, killed and left in this manner. Deb, you know, she's really, I admire her. She wants to do the right thing. She wants to work on this case, but she can't. She's not supposed to, but then she figures a way around it where she's gonna work on the case because it shows the actress, Jackie, that she can, you know, how the whole process works. So she's showing her how the system works without officially being on the system. But I mean, what else is she gonna do? I mean, if you have someone shadowing you, you should probably be doing real work, you know, so the person can see. Anyway, so, but Dexter, he is sexually attracted to Jackie, the actress, which I find very interesting considering this book was written in 2013. And this reminds me of two different things on the TV show. Now in season 2, that was shot in 2007, that was 6 years before this book was written, and Dexter cheats on Rita with Lila. You know, that wasn't really a thing where he was really in love with her. I don't think so. But then we have Hannah McKay, which Dexter was actually attracted to. That happened in season 7 in 2012. So that was a year before this book was published. And now in this book, we have Dexter being attracted to Jackie, a movie actress. It's strange. I'm okay with it because it happened on the show, but it does seem very uncharacteristic of Dexter to be having these feelings for someone like Jackie. While she is very good looking, Dexter has never really been into women, ever. Except now there's this beautiful actress and for some reason he's attracted to her. But there isn't really a motivation for that, except maybe to get famous. I don't know, he seems like someone who wants to hide in the shadows. He wants to be inconspicuous. He wants to blend in with the crowd. And so on the show, I don't really have a problem with him being attracted to Hannah McKay because she was a killer herself. yes, she was beautiful, but she was also, like, killing men, or she was killing people, just like Dexter. So they had this sort of commonality. And Jackie does not kill people. She's just a normal Hollywood actress. It's a little weird. However, this book is setting up for the final book. There's only one book left after this, and everything that happens in this book kind of culminates, and we're gonna see the aftermath of it and the final push of the series to the end. It was interesting enough. I gave it 3 stars. He kind of forgot about everything. I really liked his dedication to the kids, Aster and Cody, their development, and Lillianne, but they kind of got pushed to the background. You have this sort of struggle between him and Deb because Deb sees what Dexter... Well, she has a hard time dealing with how Dexter is. She's always had a hard time with it. She sees how Dexter is around Jackie, and she realizes that Dexter is probably cheating on Rita. Dexter just ends up being one of those kind of guys. And you're like, ugh. But anyway, I mean, I don't really have a problem with him cheating on her because he never really seemed to be into her, but he was very like, oh, Rita is not beautiful anymore. She's old, tired. The kids are always screaming. It's always a struggle at home. And, you know, Rita's always stressed out because of their new home and all this stuff. Dexter just sees Jackie and he doesn't see anything like that in her. I could see why he wouldn't want to be with Rita long term, because he's not much of a family man per se, even though he does in a way care about the kids, but he doesn't really care about Rita all that much and never has, and I don't think he ever will. He's more of a solitary person, and that's probably how Dexter should be. But I look forward to reading the last book. I want to know how this all ends, because it's going to be an interesting direction. I'm sure once I get to the last one, I'll be able to say what all happens in this book, because it pretty much is setting up for the last book. And I mean, the books are a lot different than the show, so I mean, they were going in different directions. But I just wonder if this book was inspired by the series of that whole scenario of Dexter cheating and feeling attraction to someone else. But yeah, in a way, I kind of prefer the show. Sorry. I mean, the show did a really good job of representing Dexter and who he is. So let me know what you think in the comments below. And if you haven't already, why don't you subscribe? Wednesdays is Funs Day because I post videos then, and sometimes I do it more than once a week. So that's cool. Catch you later.